Yeah. I got a Falcon Northwest Talon. I can now see what the hype is all about. Let me start with this. The price tag on a system like this is gonna make you blush. Just hands down. Understand as a kid, I mean like way back in the day, I used to dream about getting a Falcon Northwest system. They made the very first one, the very first company to make gaming PCs, and they helped create the hobby that so many of us enthusiasts love. This is the father of the gaming PC. And it's insane when you just really sit back and pay attention to the details. As a former engineer and a man who loves high-end cars, this feels in so many ways like walking around like a Bugatti Chiron or a 911 GT3 RS and just admiring all the things that make this such a high-performance vehicle. You can hear Dr. Hammond say, "Oh, spared no expense." Yes, you are going to be paying for the engineering in every way. You have to think about this one differently. See, usually what we do is we say, here are like all the parts, and if you were gonna build this yourself, this is how much it would be. And yes, though we're still gonna do that for this build, it doesn't take into account all the things that are just purely unique about Falcon Northwest and the Talon system. First and foremost, this thing is built like a tank. I mean, like a tank, like 4 millimeter thick aluminum plating. In fact, there is so little plastic in these PCs that you can fit all of the plastic in the center of your hand with ease. Now, in speaking with the team at Falcon, just the front of the case alone costs more than any of your budget cases on the market. It's all custom designed, and not just with aesthetics in mind, but also thermals and even carrying the case. That's right, carrying it down to, like, here, just check this out. At the bottom, there is a handle. It's crazy. Let's just talk about the engineering when it comes to thermals. They use a custom-made 280 millimeter radiator, all-in-one liquid cooler with a massive block for cooling that has no issue covering any CPU that's out there on the market, and especially our Ryzen 7000 series. Oh, and it doesn't even stop there. They also have noise blocker E-loop fans for their radiators. And not just any noise blocker, but custom RGB noise blocker fans that are directly imported from Germany to ensure that the RGB is there for all of your RGB boosting needs without losing performance. The founder of Falcon Northwest is an aeronautical engineer, so fans are kind of his thing. In fact, here is a picture of all of the fans that they tested before settling on the noise blocker fan. So you might say they are obsessed with airflow. And I know many of you are like looking at this case and saying, what airflow? This whole thing is engineered together to work as a unit, like lungs. And I can just, you can feel just how much air is being pulled in there. And it's not just about CPU cooling, it's also about GPU cooling. And that's because of this like little 80 millimeter fan right here in the back, specifically to get airflow directly into the GPU. Now you might be thinking, well, Robey, what if it's like an ASUS Strix or a Zotac amp or an MSI? Well, that's the thing. You're only allowed to purchase in the configurator the cards that work with the specific cooling and can be integrated into the chassis. When I got this and I opened it and I saw like no Instapak, I was like, how the heck do you do this? It's physically secured via screws into the chassis via a custom bar. The team of people is obsessed, and I do mean obsessed, with making the best PCs, every part, every aspect. Even tuning the PC is rigorous and tested. All of the CPUs and RAM modules are burnt in and tested, and the ones that don't meet the standards for their systems rejected before they even make it into systems. They send you a list of items here, and let's be honest, the list is huge. I want to show you this. It's not just stuff like, did Windows 11 get installed? We're talking about your PC benchmarks, Cinebench, like all of your bench testing. You can go in your burn in, how long it was, what your score was, how much time it was. Oh, and it also even comes with documentation in here on how to keep things running optimally, even if you've had this, after you've had the system for like a year. But this is considered the highest quality UV printing in the industry. And I kid you not, it looks as good as a vinyl wrap. Now, here we can show you some other examples from their gallery, including systems they've done for like games like Halo or Outer Worlds, and even football stars and brands like AMD. Oh, and I saved the best for last. Guys, this cable management, It's spectacular. I love the stuff from Origin and Main Gear, but Falcon Northwest uses custom cable mod sleeve cables that are measured to the millimeter. So when you pop open the front or the back, it's showworthy. It's even got an awesome metal badge on the back that declares that this PC is yours. Okay, let's just show you this. I'm gonna shut down the system. It's just so whisper quiet, but check this out. I'm gonna turn it off. I thought I was good, but here, look at this. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It's beautiful. I had to stop like halfway through this because I know I'm sounding fanboyish, but when I was reading through this, like in prep for this and got to this point, I agree it sounds this way. But as someone who really likes to pursue quality, when you see something like this, it's hard not to gush. Now, one thing I want to cover before getting to the meat of the system, and that's the warranty. 3 years parts coverage, which includes parts and labor plus lifetime technical support. You get what's called Falcon's overnight service. If they can't solve the problem via technical support, then they will pick it up via overnight courier, get the issue fixed, and overnight it back to you at no cost for 1 year. I mean, obviously that's expensive, which is why they test the crap and engineer the crap out of it so you don't have to do that. But it's awesome to see a product backed with something so good. The one thing I would like to see here, and something I do appreciate about like companies like Origin and even Main Gear, is that they have 24/7 technical support, and it's nice to have like that and the other perks. But when it comes to a system at this level, I'd love to be able to get the hold of someone no matter when it's broken and start working on the issue right away. It's kind of my only gripe. So how much does the best cost then, Robey? Well, this system as configured is $6,550. But that's gonna be up to you if it's really worth it. So what do we have inside of this system then? Well, what we've got is we got an AMD Ryzen 9 7950X inside of an ASUS ROG X670E Crosshair Hero motherboard. We have 32 gigs of Kingston Fury Beast 5600 megahertz DDR5 and an NVIDIA Founders Edition RTX 3090 Ti with a Seasonic Prime PX1600. It's an ATX 3.0 power supply, because at the time, this was before the 4000 series announced, we didn't know what the power draw was gonna be. And so in the end, it ended up being overkill, but it's still really rad to have. And if we wanted to put a 4090 in it, we could, or anything that AMD releases. Now we have cable mod custom cables for all of the power connections and the GPU. And finally, we've got a 2 terabyte Kingston Fury Renegade Gen 4 NVMe SSD. The case, the cooler are all custom to Falcon Northwest. And finally, the fans are 140 millimeter and 120 millimeter and an 80 millimeter noise blocker E-loop fan. But these are custom imported from Germany because of the RGB, which is on both sides, which looks really sick. It's got RGB, but it's tasteful RGB. For the cost breakdown, Robey, how does it work out? Like, if I wanted to build this system myself, how would you figure it out? CPU, motherboard, RAM, GPU, PSU, and storage are all pretty straightforward. And you can just price those out on the website. You figure the fans, we figured $40 a piece if you weren't gonna get the like custom RGB ones. And I figured $250, maybe more for the AIO, accounting for the custom nature. And this is, guys, this is speculation because again, we don't know exactly what it is. Custom cables, if you were gonna go do it, they'd be about $350. Now the case, this is interesting because you're looking at the quality of this case and all the custom engineering and materials. Then you're probably gonna need to look at something like the Inwin D frame to come to, like when we think about a cost comparison, and that's about $1,500. So the case is pricey. I think with tuning and experience and everything else, you're talking about $1,000 overhead just to own a Falcon Northwest system. Now, a lot of speculation there, but you get a 3-year warranty, a year of overnight plus lifetime technical support. That's a lot, and it's going to be up to you if that's actually worth it. But how does it actually perform? We have to think about cooling on a Ryzen 7000 system in a completely different way. Here is the deal direct from the mouth of AMD. In the Ryzen 7000 series, the processor is designed to run at TJ Maxx 24/7 without any risk of damage or deterioration. At 95 degrees, it is not running hot. Rather, it will intentionally go to this temperature as much as possible under load because the power management system knows that this is the ideal way to squeeze the most performance out of the chip without damaging. Now, it runs at max heat to get peak performance on purpose. So what we have to do is look at the performance of the system when in open and closed case. So in open case versus closed case, we saw an average core clock speed reduction of 100 megahertz per core and a loss on Cinebench of about 450 points. So let me just put this another way. We tested, as part of our review, a 7950X on an open air bench using an X73 AIO, with the correct AM5 bracket. Yes, you have to worry about that. With three T30 fans set to advance, running at 3000 RPM and having a CFM of 7.11. The CPU multi-threaded Cinebench score, which was 37,716. On our close case, we saw the Falcon Northwest hit 37,806. The cooling is fine. So what about the GPU then, Robey? How does that do in terms of open case and close case? Well, funny enough, that 80 millimeter noise blocker, it's the same. See, at idle, it's 37, and under load, it's 85 on the 38 and 3090 Ti. So open or close, the GPU temperature was absolutely the same. So if I ripped all the panels off and just let this thing suck in air, the temperature was the same in both cases. That's pretty crazy. Now for the fun part, because this is a whole new ball game when we get to talk about gaming. And unlike any other pre-built PC we've ever got to do, we are getting to test AMD's newest flagship, the 7950X. So here is our standard suite of games using the Ryzen 9 7950X with the RTX 3090 Ti. First up, we got Cyberpunk 2077 at 1440p with settings all set to ultra, DLSS set to ultra performance, as we saw 122.5 frames per second. Next up, we got Shadow the Tomb Raider running with RTX on at the highest preset. Again, with DLSS set to ultra performance, we see 254 frames per second. We got Metro Exodus, just one of those crazy bring your system to its knees titles like Cyberpunk. Again, everything set to max and DLSS set to balance, we see things running at 116.87 frames per second. Now onto some AMD optimized title, Dirt 5 at 1440p with ultra preset, you're looking at 164.8 frames per second. For Tiny Tina's Wonderland, which, guys, we've retired Borderlands 3, by the way, again, set to the highest graphical preset and setting FSR 2.0 to performance, we got 196.06 frames per second. Okay, so what about multiplayer, Robey? If I was gonna spend this kind of money on a system and I wanted to be like an eSport practice pro, what would I do? Let's start with Apex Legends running at 1440p, optimized for a frame rate, and playing competitively, we see 277.7 frames per second. For Valorant, we saw 603.9. And finally, it's time for Fortnite. Again, same thing, 1440p, lowest visual settings, and running on way more than a potato. How about 424.2 frames per second? Oh, and did I mention how insanely quiet it is? And I do mean insanely quiet. I mean, the funny thing is for half of this review, this has been running Cinebench. Yeah, did you notice? Remember when I shut it off and yeah, that was running Cinebench and you couldn't even hear it. Okay, so wrap it up, Robey, what did you think? I can now see without a doubt what all the fuss is about when it comes to a Falcon Northwest system and why the people who love them buy their systems. It's some big celebrity names, but there's also names on there who have like incredible taste in systems, like John Carmack and Lisa Su and Mark Rain and like Unreal, who have expectations and need the systems to perform without having any issues whatsoever. I mean, every single detail from performance, software, engineering, and aesthetics have all been obsessed over. And it comes out in how Falcon Northwest backs its products and even the documentation, the paper that you get with the system. I mean, I've spent a ton of time now and email correspondence with their owner, Kelt Reeves, and there is no small measure of passion that comes through in everything we talked about when working with them on this review. It's pure passion transformed into product. But it is a very hefty price. These systems aren't cheap, and there are no two ways about it. You can build a system that performs close enough for way less. This is not for everyone. Heck, I would say this isn't for most people. And you know what? Falcon Northwest knows that. Neither are Bugattis or Ferraris or Tag Heuer or Rolexes or other supremely crafted pieces of technology. They don't pretend to be. And honestly, I would rather have that from Falcon Northwest than from a company like, you know, Overkill, who's pretending their prices aren't inflated. Come on, guys, they still haven't fixed that. I will say, you get what you pay for, but the value is definitely going to be in the eye of the beholder. So if you want it and you can afford it, do it. I'm really glad, like abundantly glad, that I got to spend the time I got to with this system. It's engineering excellence. And if I had and I could spend the money on a pre-built, I would absolutely not be disappointed on a system like this. But you know what? It's not about what I think, and I can already picture the comments, but I still really want to know your thoughts. And you know what? you might be able to win a little cash in the process. First and foremost, you need to leave a quality comment down below, along with liking and subscribing to the channel. Now, when I say quality comment, it doesn't need to be positive. I really do want to know what you think. It just needs to be something you either liked or didn't like about the video, what surprised you about the performance or the Falcon Northwest Talon, or even the AMD Ryzen 9 7950X. Just not, hey, I deserve to win a free PC, and can you send me that really awesome PC for free? Nothing weird or lame like that. You also need to ensure we have a way to reach you via your YouTube profile. So like, put your email in your YouTube profile so we can like get a hold of you, because we're gonna be giving away $25 to one lucky comment down below that is worldwide, as long as you can accept PayPal or Venmo. If we don't have your email in your YouTube profile, then we can't tell you you've won, and therefore you can't win. So, what are your thoughts? Oh, and I did wanna address one thing. We're not using your email for anything else. It's just to email you and tell you you've won if you won. So, what are your thoughts on the Falcon Northwest Talon? Did the cooling and performance stuff actually surprise you? What about the price? Did you have to do a double take? And what are your thoughts in comparing something like this to like a high-end hypercar or other automobile or watch or whatever? I'd love to know all that and more down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robeytech. Did you guys know we have a live stream channel for special builds and events? In fact, we're gonna be doing and have bench tested this live right before this video went live. So if you wanna see this or basically watch us do pre-built testing like this, check out Robeytech Live down in the description below so you can like and subscribe to know when we go live and you don't miss content like this live. Do you have questions about pre-builts or any other tech-related questions? Then check out our amazing Discord server over at discord.gg/Robeytech, filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to share their thoughts and ideas on all of those very subjects. Are you looking for cheap tech? Not like this Falcon Northwest system? Then check out @Robeytech.com or @RobeytechDeals on Twitter, where we have our guide Tom scouring the internet for the best deals on new tech, TV, GPUs, even GPU or CPU availability given Ryzen just launched. Finally, you can also follow me and my entire team on all the other socials @Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Super appreciate the support from AMD and Falcon Northwest, who did not sponsor this video, by the way, but did let us get to test this really awesome hardware. And we look forward to seeing you on the next one. Thanks, guys.